Now I'm making sarsaparilla tablets today. So all I need to do is add in about half a cup of sarsaparilla concentrated essence and then a tiny dash of red colour. And then I'm always very, very gentle when I mix it in, because this sugar's so hot, I don't want to go splashing it around the place. Yeah. Right, you can just see from the way that's evaporating just how hot the sugar is. I've cooked it to 140. It'll have cooled a bit now. It'll be about 130 at the minute. Yes, it is. It's very strong when it's hot. Now you can see as I run my knife through that it's very much a liquid in the centre of these two bars. But towards the edges it'll have set solid already just from touching the cold steel. So all I need to do with it now is keep the whole thing moving. I don't want it to set in layers like this. If I were to leave it, I'd end up with one big pane of glass. But what I want to end up with is a nice, soft lump of sugar that feels something like Play-Doh. So until it cools down to that point, I'm just going to keep messing about with it. This is probably the easiest part of the job. It is very strong, isn't it? How do you think I feel? I've always got a roll of corn flour to hand because sugar's awful sticky stuff. But if you've got plenty of flour on your gloves, in theory it shouldn't stick to you. What I'm going to do is just spread it out nice and thin in the hope that it'll cool off a bit faster. I can feel that it's really becoming quite solid now. So I'll use a bit more corn flour just to brighten up the colour. And then I just have to knead it up like bread dough. And that'll probably mix in all of the colour and flavour. And it softens up the finished sweet just very slightly. Makes it just about biteable, so you should never bite a boiled sweet. And there, that essentially is the finished sweet now that it's all been kneaded slightly and all the colours properly mixed in. It's still far too hot to be able to shape, but if I'm fast I can get ahead of myself now and just chop it up into smaller pieces. Just about cool enough to handle, just. See, while the sugar's still soft, it's very inclined to misshape itself in the roller. Still a little bit soft, I'm going to give it another minute or two. Wow. very early days, a lot of confectioners would have pulled and shaped their sugar completely by hand. But by the Edwardian era, we're a bit more technologically advanced. And you can see, even though it's starting to crack a little, the last one I put through is still very flexible. It's still warm. The longer it sits in that lump, even if the outer skin solidifies, the inside stays soft. But with any luck, the first few that I've made should set there. They are. Once the sugar hardens again, they all just pop apart. And they're covered in little sharp edges at this stage, just like broken glass. So, for absolute perfection, every single piece is hand-cut. Luckily, not individually.